50% of the money and the program gets 50%.
Woohoo!
We're also raffling off our very cool Fiddler Swag t-shirts for only $2 per raffle ticket if you'd like to enter. Please make sure to silence your cell phones, no food or drink in the theater, and no popcorn.
And before we begin, we'd like to just share that the decision to put on Fiddler on the Roof was made during the summer at a time when it still felt like a tale of a lost world. Unfortunately, world events since then have reminded us what a contemporary and relevant story it still is. And whereas we might have questioned putting on almost any other show at this time, we never doubted that this is a story that needs to be retold, especially now. So with that,
Fiddler on the Roof. Sounds crazy, no? Well, you might say, every one of us, not a captain, is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a pleasant, simple food without breaking his neck. It isn't easy. You may ask, why do we stay up there and it's so dangerous? We stay because Anatefka is our home. How do we keep our balance? Well, that I can tell you in one word. Tradition!
Raise a family and bond on.
Finish in the barn. I want to speak to Yendova. Can I go out and play?
You have feet.
Go.
Can I go too?
Go too.
But Mama, the men she finds, the last one was so old and he was bald. He had no hair.
A poor girl with no dowry can't afford to be so picky. You want hair? Marry the monkey.
After all, Mama, I'm not yet 20 years old.
Shh! Do you have to boast about your age? Do you want to tempt the evil eye? Here, inside.
Every day of the week news, but once in a lifetime news. Where are the boys? They're outside, no? Good. Such diamonds, such jewels. You'll see, Golda, I will find every one of them a husband. But you shouldn't be so picky, because even the worst husband, God forbid, is better than no husband, God forbid. And who should know better than me? Ever since my husband died, I've been a poor widow. All alone, no one to talk to, nothing to say to anyone. It's no life. All I do at night is think of him. And even thinking of him gives me no pleasure, because you know as well as I, he was not much of a person. He never made a living. Everything he touched turned to mud. But still, better than nothing.
Good evening. Is Cycle in the house?
But she's busy. Come back later.
There's something I'd like to tell her.
Later.
Oh, not till I thought I heard you.
You go back to what you were doing. I said later.
So, what does that poor little Taylor Muttley want with someone?
Oh, they've been friends since they were children. They talk, they play.
They play? What do they play?
Who knows? They're just children.
From such children come other children.
Motto is a nothing.
Ah, children, yes. Children. They're a blessing in your old age. My Aaron, may he rest in peace, couldn't give me children. Believe me, he was as good as gold. Never raised his voice to me, but otherwise, not so much of a man. So what good is it if he never raised his voice? Still, what's the use complaining? Other women, they enjoy complaining, but not Yenta. No, not every woman in the world is a Yenta. So I must go prepare my poor Sabbath table. So goodbye, Golda. And it was a pleasure talking our hearts out to each other.
Yenta, you said you had news for me.
Ah! I'm losing my head. One day, it's gonna fall off altogether, and a horse is gonna kick it in the mud, and woohoo, goodbye, Henta. Of course, the news. It's about Laser Wolf the Butcher. A good man, a fine man, and I don't have to tell you that he's well off. But he's lonely, the poor man. A widower, you understand. Of course, you do something. To make it short, out of the whole town, he's cast his eye on Cycle.
My Cycle?
No, the Tsar's Cycle. Of course your Cycle!
Such a match for my Cycle. But Teffy wants a learned man. He doesn't like Laser.
Listen to me, Goldie. Send Teffy to him. Don't tell him what it's about. He's a good man. He'll win him over. He's a good man and a wealthy man, true? Of course true. So, you'll tell me how it went, and you don't have to thank me, because aside from my fee, which Laser will pay anyway, it just gives me satisfaction to make people happy. And what better satisfaction is there? So, goodbye, Golda, and you're welcome.
What you want, Mama?
When I want you to know, I'll tell you. Go finish washing the floor.
I wonder if Yenta found a husband for you.
I'm not anxious for Yenta to find me a husband.
Not unless it's Muttle, the tailor.
I didn't ask you.
Seidel, you're the oldest. They have to make a match for you before they can make one for me. And then after her, one for me.
So if Yenta brings you a match.
Oh, Yenta.
Well, somebody has to arrange the matches. Young people can't decide these things for themselves.
She might bring someone wonderful.
Someone interesting.
And well off.
And important. Matchmaker, make me a match. Find me a find. Catch me a catch.
to our family. So whatever Yenta brings, you'll take, right?
Of course, right.
Just for show.
fill my yard with chips and turkeys and geese and ducks for the town to see and hear. Squawking just as noisily as they can. And each loud will land like a trumpet on the ear, as if to say, here lives a wealthy man. If I were rich,
places they can't reach.
Amen!
Why do you curse them? What good does your cursing do? All you do is chatter. You curse and chatter and stand around and don't do anything at all. You'll chatter yourself all the way to the grave.
Excuse me, you're not from this village.
No.
And where are you from?
Yeah, I'm a student at the university then.
Ah, the university. Is that where you learn to criticize your elders?
That's where I learned there's more to life than just talk. You have to know what's happening in the outside world.
Why should we break our heads about the outside world? Let them break their own heads.
He's right.
That's not.
The book says. You spit in the air, it lands on your face.
That is nonsense. You can't close your eyes to what's happening in the world.
He's right. Hurry. He's right. And he's right. How can they both be right? You know what? They're also right.
He's right. He's wet behind the ears. Good Sabbath, Tevye.
Sabbath must take this.
Tevye, the rabbi's order, my cheese.
Yes, of course, of course. So, you're from Kiev, Reb.
Perchik.
Perchik. You're a newcomer here. As Abraham said, I am a stranger in a strange land.
Moses said that.
Forgive me. As King David put it, I am slow of speech and slow of tongue.
That was also Moses.
Somebody with a slow tongue, he talked a lot.
And the cheese?
Yes, of course. Here, have some.
I have no money, and I am not a beggar.
It's a blessing for me to give.
Very well. For your sake.
Thank you. You know, Reb Perchik, it's no crime to be poor.
The only criminals are the rich. One day all their riches will be ours.
If they will agree, I will agree.
And who will make this miracle come to pass?
People. Ordinary people.
Like you?
Like me.
Nonsense.
Until your golden day comes, Reb Perchik, how will you live?
By teaching children. Do you have any children?
I have five daughters.
Five? Girls should learn too. Girls are people.
Oh, radical!
I would be willing to teach them. Open their minds up to many great thoughts.
What kind of thoughts?
Well, the Bible has many lessons for our times.
I'm a very poor man. Fruitful lessons. Good. Come. Stay the Sabbath with us. Of course, we don't eat like kings, but we don't starve either. As the good book says, when a poor man eats a chicken, one of them is sick.
Where does the book say that?
Well, it doesn't exactly say that, but somewhere, someplace, it says something about a chicken. Who's that? This is mine, mwah! And this is mine, oh, and this is mine, and this is not mine. Perchik, this is my consort. At least we tell her he's going to be around.
So you did me a favor and came in.
This is also mine. Although this is Perchik, from Kiev. He'll be staying the Sabbath with us. He's a teacher. Children, would you like to take lessons from him?
I am a really good teacher, a very good teacher.
I heard once. The rabbi who must praise himself has a congregation of one.
Your daughter has a quick and witty tongue.
Which gets from me, as the good book says.
The good book can wait, go get washed.
Tongue she gets from her mother.
Michael, you'll also be eating with us? Of course, another blessing. Cycle, two more. Spritz the Bielko, go get washed.
Michael can help me.
How about you go too? Get the table. You can wash outside by the well. Tevye, I have something to say to you.
Why should today be any different?
Tevye, I have to tell you.
I pray. I'll look him, Mama.
Laser Wolf wants to speak to you.
The butcher? About what?
I don't know. Only he says it's important.
Why can it be so important? I have nothing to slaughter him. I saw mother in a pint of
after the Sabbath, go see him and talk to him.
Why can it be so important? If he's thinking about buying my new milk cow, he can forget it.
Tevye, don't be an ox. A man sends an important message. The least you could do is talk to him.
What's important? He wants to buy my new milk out.
Talk to him.
All right. After the Sabbath, I'll talk to him. I'm in.
Someone who will be a match, and then it would be too late for us. Don't worry, Tzeltal. I found someone who will sell me his used sewing machine. So in a few weeks, I'll have saved up enough to buy it, and your father will be impressed with me.
Tzeltal, a few weeks may be too late.
But what else can we do?
You can ask my father for my hand tonight. Now.
Why should you consider me now? I'm only a poor tailor.
And I'm only the daughter of a poor milkman. Just talk to him.
Tzeltal, if your father says no, that's it. It's final. Yell at me.
Mwato.
I'm just a poor tailor.
Mwato. Even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness.
That's true.
Will you talk to him? Will you talk to him?
All right. I'll talk to him.
Come, children. Slave. Come on. Slave.
Repetio.
Where's everybody? Where is him? What, Mwato?
Repetio.
What, Mwato? What, Mwato?
Good Sabbath, Lepepe.
Sabbath. Come, go, the children! Get the light of the candles! It's late!
Wonderful! And I'll be happy to make things merry.
We need somebody dancing, you know, for a small fee, naturally.
Naturally. A wedding's no wedding without you and your fee.
Good evening, innkeeper.
Good evening.
We'd like a drink. Sit, Vietka, sit.
Vodka schnapps?
Vodka.
Right away.
Good evening.
Good evening, Tevye.
What are you doing here so early?
He wants to buy my new milk. Good evening, Rebeza.
Ah, Tevye, sit down. Have a drink.
I won't insult you by saying no.
How goes it with you, Tevye?
How should it go?
You're right.
And you?
The same.
Sorry to hear that.
So, how's your brother-in-law in America?
I believe he's doing very well.
Oh, he wrote you?
Not lately.
Then how do you know?
He's doing badly. You're right.
Tevye, I suppose you know why I wanted to see you.
Yes, sir, please. I'm sorry about this. No reason to talk about it.
Why not?
Why, yes. Why should I get rid of her?
Well, you have a few more without her.
I see. Then you want one. Tomorrow, you may want two.
Two? What would I do with two?
Same as you do with one.
Tevye, this is very important to me.
Why is this so important to you?
Frankly, because I'm lonesome.
Awesome. What are you talking about?
You don't know?
You're talking about my new milk cow. What do you want to buy from me?
A milk cow? So I won't be lonesome?
What's so funny?
I was talking about your daughter Tsaitel.
Daughter Tsaitel?
Of course your daughter Tsaitel. I see her in my butcher shop every Thursday. She's made quite an impression on me. I like her. And as for me, Tevye, as you know, I have my own house, a store, a servant. I don't have to try and impress you. Let's just shake on it and call it a match. And besides, you won't need a dowry for her. And you may find a little something in your own purse, too.
Shame! Shame on you! What do you mean, my own purse? Psyche's not the sort I would sell for money. Shame!
All right. We don't have to talk about money, just as you said. The main thing is, let's just get it done with. Tevye, I'll be good to her. I like her. What do you think?
What do I think? What do I think? I never liked her. Why should I? You could have a fine conversation with her if you talk about kidneys and livers. On the other hand, not everyone has to be a scholar. You're rich enough. Always gonna call you stupid. On the other hand, he's got a problem. Older than him. That's her problem. She's much younger. That's his problem. I always thought of him as a butcher. But I misjudged him. He's a good man. He likes him. He'll try to make her happy. What do I think? It's a match.
You agree?
I agree.
Oh, Tevye, that's wonderful. Let's drink on it.
Why not? To you.
No, my friend, to you.
To the both of us.
To our agreement.
To our agreement. To our prosperity. To our good health and happiness. But most important, to life. To life. L'chaim. L'chaim, l'chaim, to life. Here's to the father I try to be.
Here's to my bride to be.
Drink l'chaim.
Tevye, to Tsaitel, your daughter,
my wife,
and I return Tevye is marrying off his oldest daughter.
Oh, may I offer my congratulations, Tevye.
Thank you, Your Honor.
Tevye, there's a piece of news I think I should tell you, as a friend. Now, I'm giving this news because I like you. You're a decent, honest person, even though you are a Jewish dog. Akira, how often does a man get a compliment like that? And your news. We received orders that sometime soon this district is to have a little unofficial demonstration.
Program here?
No. Just a little unofficial demonstration.
How little?
Not too serious. Just a mischief. So if the inspector comes through, we'll see we have done our duty. Now, personally, I don't know why there has to be this trouble between people. But I thought I should tell you, and you can tell the others.
Thank you, you're a decent man. And you don't mind me saying, it's too bad you're not a Jew.
Oh, that's what I like about you, Tevye. Always joking. And congratulations again for your daughter.
Thank you, Your Honor. Good evening. Dear God, did you have to bring news like that today of all days? I know we're the chosen people. Once in a while, wouldn't you choose somebody else? Anyway, thank you for sending a husband. My good son. Lachaya!
If Jacob had worked for him for 7 years.
Was Laban a mean man?
Laban was an employer. Now, after 7 years of working for him, do you know what happened? He tricked him. Laban had given him his ugly daughter Leah instead. Now, to marry Rachel, Jacob had to work for him another 7 years. Now, the Bible clearly teaches us that you must never trust an employer. Do you understand? Very good. Now,
Papa, is it not yet?
No, Mom.
Well, enough lessons. We have to do Papa's work for him. How long can a man sleep? He staggered home last night and fell into bed like a dead man. I couldn't get a word out of him. Put that away and go clean the barn. Call me when Papa gets up.
That was a very interesting lesson, Perchick.
Do you think so?
Although I don't know if the rabbi would agree with your interpretation.
Neither, I suppose, would the rabbi's son.
My little sisters have big tongues.
And what do you know about him, other than he is the rabbi's son? Would you still be interested in him if he were the shoemaker's son? Or the tinsmith's son?
At least I know this. He doesn't have any strange ideas about turning the world upside down.
Certainly, any new ideas for you would be considered strange. Remember, the Lord said, let there be light.
Yes. But he was not talking to you personally.
You have spirit, maybe even a little intelligence.
Thank you.
But what good is your brain? Without curiosity, it is a rusty tool. Good day, Huddle.
We have an old custom here. A boy acts respectfully to a girl. But of course, that is too traditional for an advanced thinker like you.
Our traditions! Nothing must change! Everything is perfect, exactly the way it is!
We like our ways.
Our ways are changing everywhere but here. Men and women can't be near each other. Men must study. Women in the kitchen. Boys and girls can't touch each other. Cannot even look at each other.
I am looking at you.
You are very brave. Did you know that in the city, boys and girls can show affection to one another without the approval of a matchmaker? They can hold hands, even dance together. New dances. Like this. Do you like it? I learned it in Kiev.
Yes, it's very nice.
Butcher?
I knew it. My heart told me this would be our lucky day. Oh, dear Lord, I thank thee. I thank thee.
What do you say, Simon?
What did she say? My firstborn a bride. May you grow old with him in fortune and honor. Not like that first wife of his, from a Sarah, she should rest in peace. She was a bitter woman. Not like mine, Saito. Now I must go and thank Yenta. Mine, Saito, a bride!
Mazel tov, Saito. You call that a mazel tov? And you, Aunt Gretchen, you're not going to congratulate her.
Congratulations, Seidel, on marrying a rich man.
Again, the courage. What's wrong with being rich?
It's no reason to marry. Money is the world's curse.
May the Lord smite me with it, and may I never recover. Seidel knows. I mean only for her welfare. Is that right, Seidel?
Yes, Papa.
You see?
I see. I see very well.
You, Seidel, might speak up. So silent.
Oh,
aren't you happy with this blessing?
Papa, Papa, I can't marry him. I don't want to marry him.
What is it? What do you mean you can't marry him? If I say you will, you will.
Papa, if it's a matter of money, I'll do anything. I'll hire myself out as a servant. I'll dig ditches. I'll haul rocks. Only don't make me marry him, Papa, please.
What's the matter with Laser? He likes you.
Papa, I will be unhappy with him. All my life will be unhappy. I'll haul rocks.
But we made an agreement. And with us, an agreement is an agreement.
Papa, is that more important than I am? Papa, don't force me. I'll be unhappy all my days.
Shh. Come. I won't force you.
Oh, thank you, Papa.
It seems as if it was not ordained that you should have all the pleasures in life, but that your mother and I might have some joy in our old age.
Rebecca! May I speak with you?
Not now, not now.
I'd like to speak with you.
Later, I have problems.
Well, that's what I'd like to speak with you about. I think I can help.
Certainly. Like a bandage can help a corpse.
At least listen to him, Papa.
All right. You have a tongue? Pop.
I hear that you are arranging a match for Zeitel.
Yes, yours too.
I have a match for Zeitel.
What kind of match?
The perfect fit.
Perfect fit.
Like a glove.
Like a glove.
This match was made exactly to
perfect
measure.
Perfect fit, made to measure. Stop talking like a tailor and tell me who it is.
Please don't shout at me.
All right. Who is it?
Who is it?
Who is it? Who is it?
Me? Myself.
Yes. Himself. Either you're totally out of your mind, or you're crazy. What are you? Raising for yourself? Are you the matchmaker, the bridegroom, the guest, all rolled up into one? I suppose you want to perform the ceremony. You must be crazy.
I'm not crazy. As for being my own matchmaker, I know it's a little unusual.
Unusual? It's crazy!
Times are changing, Artevia. The thing is, your daughter, Seidel, and I gave each other a pledge over a year ago that we would marry.
You gave each other a pledge?
Yes, Papa, we gave each other a pledge.
They gave each other a pledge. Unheard of, absurd. They gave each other a pledge, unthinkable. Where do you think you are? In Moscow? In Paris? Where do they think they are? America. And what do you think you're doing? You nothing. You Stitcher. And who do you think you are? King Solomon. This isn't how it's done. Not here. Not now. Some things I will not and cannot allow. Tradition. Marriages must be arranged by the Papa. This should never be changed. One little time I pull out a frock. Where does it stop? Where does it stop? Where does it stop? Don't I have anything to say about my daughter? But doesn't nobody ask the father anymore?
I've been meaning to ask you for quite some time, Artevia. I just wanted to save up to buy my own sewing machine.
Stop talking nonsense. You're just a poor tailor.
That's right, Octavia. But even a poor tailor is entitled to some happiness. I promise you, your daughter will not starve.
He's beginning to talk like a man. On the other hand, what kind of match would that be with a poor tailor? On the other hand, he's an honest, hard worker. On the other hand, there's absolutely nothing. On the other hand, things can't get worse for him. They can only get better. They gave each other a pledge. Unheard of, absurd. They gave each other a pledge, unthinkable. But look at my daughter's face. She loves him, she wants him. And look at my daughter's eyes, so hopeful. Tradition! Very well, children. When do we make a wedding?
Thank you, Papa!
Oh, Rattabia, you won't be sorry.
I won't be sorry. I'm sorry already!
Thank you, Papa!
Thank you, Papa!
They gave each other their trust. Fun children. Golden. What am I going to do about Golden? What am I going to say to Golden? Help!
Muscle, you were wonderful!
It was a miracle! Oh, it was a miracle! Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took Daniel once again, stood by his side, and miracle of miracles, walked him through the lion's den. Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, I was afraid that God would frown. So long ago in Jericho, God just made a wall fall down. When Moses softened Pharaoh's heart, that was a miracle. When God made the waters of the Red Sea part, that was a miracle too. But of all God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is that out of a worthless lump of clay, God has made a man today. Woo! Wonder of wonders, miracle of miracles, God took a tailor by the hand, turned him around, and miracle of miracles led him to the promised land. When David slew Goliath, yes, that was a miracle. When God gave us manna in the wilderness, God's miracles, large and small, the most miraculous one of all is the one I thought would never be. God has given you.
Some celebration of some sort. Everyone we knew was there. Musicians
privilege ring. Out comes your Grandma Saito.
Grandma Saito? How'd she look?
A woman who's dead 30 years. She looked very good. Naturally, I went up and I greeted her. And she said to me,
I'm sorry. think to hear such a dog and honorable queen, and to think they was brought on by that butcher. If Lord Grandma Cycle, may she rest in peace, took the trouble to come all the way from the other world to tell us about the tailor, then all we could say is it's all for the best, and it couldn't possibly be any better. Amen.
Amen.
The shop for a few minutes. I'll be right back.
Of course.
We heard about your sister. Mazel tov, Mazel tov.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Mazel tov.
Please, may I pass?
Why? We just want to congratulate you. Mazel tov.
All right, stop it.
What's with you, Fietka?
Just stop it.
Now listen, Fietka.
Goodbye, Sasha. I said goodbye. Sorry about that. They mean no harm.
Don't they? Is there something you want?
I'd like to talk with you.
I'd rather not.
I've often noticed you at the booksellers. Not many girls in the village like to read. Would you like to borrow this book? It's very good.
No, thank you.
Why? Because I'm not Jewish. Do you feel about us the way that they feel about you? I didn't think you would.
What do you know about me?
Let me tell you about myself. I'm a pleasant fellow. Charming, honest, ambitious, quite bright, and very modest.
I don't think we should be talking this way.
I often do things I shouldn't. Go ahead, take the book. It's by Heinrich Heine. Happens to be Jewish, I believe.
That doesn't matter.
You're quite right. Good. After you've returned it, I'll ask you how you've liked it. We'll talk about it for a while, then we'll talk about life and how we feel about things. And it can all turn out quite pleasant.
Fietka, can I help you with something?
No. Thank you.
Oh, you forgot your book.
No, it's mine.
Thank you, Chava.
Good day, Chava.
Good day.
Fietka.
Good day, Fietka.
Thank you.
carry? Is this the little boy at play?
Sunrise, sunset, swiftly through the day.
gathered here to celebrate in the joy of the newlyweds, Muttle and Saito. May they live together in peace to a ripe old age. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, and here comes our beloved rabbi. May he be with us for many, many years.
Amen.
Amen.
I'd like to announce that the parents of the bride are giving the newlyweds the following. One new doosbed. Featherbed, thank you. A pair of pillows.
Goose pillows!
That's it. And a pair of candlesticks. Oh. Now let us not, in our time of joy, forget those who are no longer with us. Our dear departed, who lived in pain and poverty and hardship, and who died in pain and poverty and hardship. But enough tears! Let's be merry and content, like our good friend Laser Wolf,
who
has everything in the world, except a bride. But Laser Wolf has no ill feelings. In fact, he has a gift for the newlyweds that he would like to announce himself. Come, Laser Wolf.
Like he said, I have no ill feelings. What's done is done. I'm giving the newlyweds 5 chickens. Wow. One for each of the first 5 Sabbaths of their wedded life.
Yes. And Laser, you're a decent man. On behalf of my daughter and her new husband, I accept your gift. And there's a famous saying that says...
Estesia, I'm not marrying your daughter. I don't need to listen to your saying.
If you just wait a second, I was only going to say that you have...
Why should I listen to you, a man who'd break an agreement?
Not now, Laser. In the middle of a wedding.
I have a right to talk.
What right? It's not your wedding.
It should have been.
But Laser, don't shame Reptavia at his daughter's wedding.
He shamed me in front of the whole village.
Rabbi, say something. Let's sit down.
You all heard the wise words of the rabbi.
Now, I'd like to sing a song.
You can keep me diseased chickens.
Keep my chickens out of this. We had a bargain. We drank on it.
I saw that they drank on it.
We're not done.
Done is done.
Once a butcher, always a butcher.
I had a sign. My grandmother came to me. Well, my grandfather came to me from the grave and told me that your grandmother was a big liar.
Oh, we drank on it.
What?
I'm singing.
Quiet! Quiet! What is this screaming? They drank on it. There was an agreement. None of that matters. Saito wanted to marry Muddle, not Laser.
A young girl decides for herself?
Why not? They're in love.
Love?
Terrible.
He's a radical.
What happens to the matchmaking?
I don't know.
Let's sit down.
Play! A dance! Come, dance! It's a wedding!
Stop the wedding!
Hey, what's it doing?
It's happening!
Who will dance with me?
That's a sin!
It is no sin to dance at a wedding.
With a girl?
That's what comes from bringing a wild man into your house.
He's not a wild man. Some of his ideas are a little different.
It's a sin!
It's not a sin. Ask the rabbi. Come on, ask him.
Rabbi.
Dancing? Well, it's not exactly forbidden.
You see, it's not forbidden.
And it's not a sin. But now, who will dance with me?
Huddle! It's only a dance, Mama.
Play!
Look, it's Evian's daughter!
She's dancing with a man!
I see we came at a bad time, Tevye. I am sorry, but the orders are for tonight, for the whole village. Go on, play. Play! All right. Terribly sorry, Tevye. You understand?
We understand.
Come.
Take him into the house.
Why are we all standing around? Clean up. Clean up.
You're asking me to marry you.
In a theoretical sense.
Yes, I am.
I was hoping you were.
Then I take it that you approve, and that we can consider ourselves engaged even though I'm going away. Oh, I'm happy, Huddle. Very happy.
So am I, Bridget.
I used to tell myself that I had everything, but that was only half true. I had an aim in life, and that was everything, but now I even have you. I have something that I could die for, someone that I can live for too. Yes, now I have everything, not only everything, I have a little.
Love her.
You love her.
Look, it's a new style. I made a decision without the parents, without a matchmaker. After all, did Adam and Eve have a matchmaker? Yes. Yes, they did. Seems as if these two have the same matchmaker. They're going over my head. Unheard of. Absurd. With this, they want to be blessed. Impossible. I'll lock her up in her room. I couldn't. I should. But look at my daughter's face. She loves him. Tradition! Very well, children. You have my blessing. And my permission.
Oh, thank you, Papa. You don't know how happy this makes me.
What else can I do?
Thank you, Papa.
Thank you, Papa. What am I going to tell your mother? Another dream?
Another something. Like, I'm going away to see a rich uncle. Something like that.
Please, Bertie. I know how to handle my own wife. Go there! Go there! Go there! Talking to Percy and Owen.
Well?
They seem very fond of each other.
Well?
Well, I've decided to give them my permission to become engaged. Now I can own the house.
What? Just like that? Without asking me?
Who asked you? I'm the father.
What is he? A pauper. He has nothing. Absolutely nothing.
I wouldn't say that. I hear he has a rich uncle. A very rich uncle. He's a good man, Baldwin. I like him. Some of his ideas are a little crazy, but I like him. It's more important. Huddle likes him. Huddle loves him. So what can we do? It's a new world.
Thing, but even so,
after 25 years.
I'm
Arthur was also arrested. Give him regards. Moses is yours. I always thought he was a good man. Tell him I rely on his honor to treat my daughter well. Tell him that.
Papa, God alone knows when we shall see each other again.
And we will leave it in his hands. Take good care of her. See that she dresses.
No more handmade clothes.
Rabbi,
look at my new sewing machine.
Mazel tov.
Rabbi, is there a blessing for a sewing machine?
There is a blessing for everything.
Shechianu v'kimanu v'igianu lazman hazeh.
Amen!
And the baby, how's the baby?
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon, Fiedka.
I came for the shirt.
Yes, it's ready.
Look, it's our new sewing machine.
I see. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Good day.
So how does it work?
Oh, it's an amazing thing. You work it with your foot and your hand.
I will, but I'm afraid.
Papa, please, let me speak with your father.
No, that would be the worst thing, I'm sure of it.
Let me just try.
No, I'll talk to him. I promise.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Good day.
Good day. What are you talking about?
Nothing. We were just talking. Papa, Fiedka and I have known each other for a long time now.
Papa, I'd be much happier if you remain friends from a distance. You have to remember who you are and who he is.
He has a name, Papa.
Of course. All God's creatures on earth have a name.
Fiedka is not a creature, Papa. Fiedka is a man.
Who says he's not? He's just a different kind of man. As the good book says, a bird may love a fish, but where would they make a home together?
The world is changing, Papa.
No, how? Some things don't change for us. Some things will never change for us.
We don't feel that way.
We?
Fiedka and I. We want to be married.
Are you out of your mind? Do you know what that means? Marrying out of the faith.
But Papa.
No, how? Don't mention this again. Don't talk to him again. Never see him again. Never. Do you understand me?
Yes, Papa. I understand you.
Ah, you're finally here. Let's go home. It's time for dinner.
I want to see Marco's new machine.
You'll see it another time. It's late.
Quiet, woman, don't get me angry, because when I get angry, even flies don't deserve to fly.
Papa, I'm very frightened of you. When we finish supper, I'll faint.
Well, then,
come home.
I am the man of the house. I am the head of the household. I want to see Michael's new machine now. Now we can go. Why can't he work on three? I know, I'm very upset about my horse. And he's one of your creatures. He has every right that I have. The right to be sick, the right to be starved, the right to work like a horse. Dear God, I'm tired of pulling this cup. And push for a while.
Tapia.
What? What is it?
It's Ava. She left home this morning.
What?
With Fietka.
What?
I looked all over for her. I even went to the priest and he told me that they were married.
Married? Go home. We have other children at home. Go home. You have work to do. I have work to do.
But Chava!
Chava is dead to us. We'll learn to forget about her. Little bird, little Chava, I don't understand what's going on today. Everything is all a blur. All I can see is a happy child. What a little bird you were. Chavala, chavala. Little bird, little chavala. You were always such a pretty thing, everybody's favorite child. Gentle, kind, and affectionate, what a little bird you were. Chavala, chavala. On the other hand, that I turn my back on my faith and my people. If I bend that far, I will break. On the other hand, there is no other hand. No, Papa. No!
Papa!
No!
Papa!
Should I sell my house? Isn't it anybody's way?
Tevye, I came here to tell this grave to leave on a Tevka.
How did I come to deserve such an honor?
Not just you, of course, but all of you. At first I thought you might be spirit because of your daughter Chava, who married.
Chava is dead.
I understand. And it really affects all of you. You have to leave.
This little corner of the world has always been our home. Why should we leave?
I don't know why. There's trouble in the world and troublemakers.
Like us.
You're not the only ones. Your people must leave all the villages.
Solodin, Rabalevka,
the whole district must be emptied.
And you?
I have an order here. It says that you must sell your homes and be out of here in 3 days.
Three days?
You. You have known this all your life. You would carry out such an order.
I have nothing to do with this. Don't you understand?
We understand.
What if we refuse to go?
Then you will be forced out.
We will defend ourselves.
Against our army, I wouldn't advise it.
That's some advice for you. Get off my land. This is still my home. This is still my land. Get off my land.
3 days.
After a lifetime, a piece of paper and get thee out?
We should get together and review the zoologist. Maybe they have a plan.
We must defend ourselves. An eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth.
Very well. Then the whole world will be blind and toothless.
Rabbi, we've been waiting for the Messiah all our lives. Wouldn't this be a good time for him to come?
We'll have to wait for him someplace else. Meanwhile, let's start packing.
He's right. I'll see you before I go.
3 days.
I have over 100 bottles of vodka. What am I going to do with them?
Where can I go with my husband, my parents, and our 3 children?
Well, Anatevka hasn't exactly been the Garden of Eden.
That's true.
After all, what do we have here? A little bit of this. A little bit of that. A pot.
A pan.
A broom. A hat.
Someone should have set a match to this place long ago.
A bench.
A tree.
So what's the
a house.
People who pass through Anatevka don't even know they've been here.
A stick of wood. A piece of cloth.
What do we leave? Nothing much. Only Anatevka.
We'll be together soon. Until Cycle, the baby. We'll be together soon. And Martha,
That muggle's a person.
And Huddle and Perchik, when will we see them?
Well, visit us every Sabbath from Siberia. You know what she writes. He sits in prison, she works. Soon he'll be set free, and together, he'll turn the world upside down. She couldn't be happier. We'll be with our other children.
Not all.
All.
I'll be ready soon. I have to finish sweeping the floor.
Sweeping the floor?
I'm not going to leave a dirty house.
Well, maybe I'm on my way.
Where are you going, Grizzly?
Chicago in America. My wife from Acera, may she rest in peace, has a brother there.
That's nice.
I hate him. But a relative's a relative, right? Goodbye, Tevye.
Are they done in there?
Almost, Papa.
Hey, little Miss Brooke.
Papa! Papa will see you.
I want him to. I want to say goodbye to him.
He will not listen.
But at least he will hear. Maybe it would be better if I went inside and told Mama that you were here.
Papa!
Papa, we came to say goodbye. We are also leaving this place. We are going to Krakow.
We cannot stay among people who can do such things to others.
We wanted you to know that. Goodbye, Papa. Mama.
Yes, we are also moving. Some are driven away by edicts, others by silence. Come, Papa.
Goodbye, Chava, Yetka.
God be with you.
And God be with you. We'll write to you in America if you like.
We'll be staying with Uncle Avram.
Yes, Mama.
We'll be staying with Uncle Avram. We'll be staying with Uncle Avram. The whole world has to know our business.
Oh, stop yelling and finish packing. We have a train to catch.
Soldier, I don't need your advice. Cypher, don't forget the baby. Come, we have to split them. Put two bundles on the car. We have to make a train.
Goodbye, Papa.
Bye, Mother.
Goodbye, Mama.
Bye, Mother. Work hard. Come to us soon.
All right, thank you. I'll work hard.
Oh, we don't need these pots over here.
Yes, we do.
All right, we'll take them.
We're going.